Has someone ever come into your life, or someone you might have in your life, and they've come to you and they said, "I'm proud of you"? And how did that make you feel? Very recently, I celebrated my birthday, and it was an incredible milestone. It was very great to spend some time with family, and just before we ate, we invited people who were there to do some speeches if they wanted to. And I remember that my dad, he stood up and he had this whole speech planned, and he was talking about this very reading which we are reflecting on today. But as he looked me in the eye, he started crying. And as I saw him crying, I also burst into tears. He then smiled and he said with a broken voice, "My son, I am proud of you." Gosh, man. It was such an emotional 10-second speech, but it impacted me so dearly. As we would say in Cape Town, it made me feel lekker. I felt good about myself. Even though I do the best that I can do, it is nice to be acknowledged for the work and the life I live. I'm also sure that Jesus felt the same when the heavens opened up on that Transfiguration Day, and the voice of the Father said, "This is my dear Son." Other translations might say that "this is my Son, the Beloved," or "this is my Son with whom I am well pleased, with whom I am proud of." Wow, it just gives me goosebumps just hearing that. You see, this is such an important passage because it sets Jesus up to continue in his ministry. We know that Christ emptied himself of all godliness, and he became fully man, fully human. He was man in all things but sin. So there were times in Jesus's life as well where he may have felt an emotional and a psychological low. And we know that through the various verses that Jesus always went out to pray by himself, or he was in the temple, or he was on the street preaching his gospel of love. And as a human, it might have taken an incredible toll on him. There's a saying which says that you can't give if you have nothing to give. And I am sure that Jesus might have felt like this as well at times. He was giving of his all. He was giving all of himself. And as he was preparing for that walk to Calvary in the later chapters, he must have had that emotional low. He was doing all of these things. He was healing the sick. He was restoring the blind. He was making the deaf hear again. He was giving and he was preaching. And I'm sure that his emotional and psychological tank was low at that time. We know that in the verses before the Transfiguration, he was tested by the Pharisees who wanted him to perform a miracle. And he also spoke about his suffering and his death to his disciples. But after Jesus was transfigured, where his holiness and his true form as God was shown, the voice of the Father just gave him that extra bit of oomph, that extra bit of grace, and that extra bit of joy when he spoke from the cloud saying, "This is my Son in whom I'm well pleased." It's like playing a soccer match or running a race. I'm a runner, and you give it your all and you finish that race and you are placed at 20th, and your parent comes to you afterward and says, "My son, my daughter, I'm proud of you for finishing this race." Even though you lost the race, you still feel good about yourself, and you then dust yourself off and you try harder the next time, and then you are placed in the top 15, and then you are placed in the top 10 till the day that you win that race. And Jesus knew who he was, but very often his human nature just overwhelmed him. He went through all the same emotions which we go through. Just the thought of his death prior to the Transfiguration may have unsettled him emotionally. He knew why he was going to die, and he also knew that he would be raised in glory, but just that thought of the torture, just the thought of the pain and the suffering might have impacted him greatly. But the Father speaking to Jesus made him feel like he could conquer the world. And he did that. He conquered the world. He conquered death. But he didn't just conquer death. He conquered sin. And in the same way, our Heavenly Father says to each of us, "You are my son and you are my daughter. I am proud of you. He might not be proud of what we had done or what we are doing right now or the situation we find ourselves in, but he is proud of us conquering those things which had kept us and keeps us enslaved in sin. He is proud of us transforming our lives and totally surrendering ourselves to him. Jesus knows what we are going through. He knows our spiritual, our emotional, and our psychological, and even our physical highs and lows and everything in between. All the Father is telling us is to listen to the voice of Jesus. And what does Jesus say? His message is very simple, but it can be quite a difficult message to live by as well. He says, love. Love one another as I have loved you. And that is the message that is placed on each of our hearts. That's the call we are called to. But it is up to us to acknowledge Jesus as the Son of God, in whom the Father is well pleased. And it is up to us to listen to him. Amen.